Good morning, noon, evening, or night, depending when you are watching this video. My name is Legend, and welcome back to World of Tanks and the NBTT replay series. Today we are featuring Waffle 9000 in his Tier 9 British non-turreted tank destroyer, the Tortoise. Tortoise. My pronunciations can get all over the place. However, the Tortoise. Just call the Tortoise. Just speak normal English, please. The Tortoise on Berlin. Let's just... don't have the map on full size, I notice. Maybe I'll fix that in a moment. The Tortoise is... Well, we know the Tortoise. It's slow. It's fairly heavily armored. And it got an insane DPM. But since it really is immobile... Ah, there the minimap goes. Since it is really immobile, it, well, struggles. And I have played some of the lower tier slow tank destroyers of the British nation. And you sometimes get in situations that you, wow, just can't keep up with. However, in this map, in this particular section of the map, the Tortoise is going to perform excellent. But not before Waffle 9000 here really wants to deal some damage at that enemy object, which is going to take a while. Just have a look at, yeah. So after 9 shells, he finally connects the first and deals some bit of damage. Honestly, I would have stopped there a while ago after the 3rd or 4th shell, knowing that the accuracy RNG gods just would not let me. And this kind of a misplay led to the enemy team taking over the city a little bit south of Waffle 9000 here. However, this created the perfect situation though, because right now the Tortoise is in its perfect position with cover on his right flank. Hiding his only, well, major weak spot, the cupola. And you see that the enemy Tortoise doesn't do that. The other way around, it means that its cupola or weak spot could get hit easier. Although weak spot, it's still kind of weak, but it got buffed a little while ago, and it's still kind of strong, if you will. And you will see that in a few moments. So yeah, 3000 damage already, so you'll see when the Tortoise is going, it's insane. It really is insane, the DPM that this thing can put out. Only getting outperformed by a few others. But right now, with its cupola now poking out with the cover on his left, he does get hit right there. But luckily, World of Tanks has this great mechanic in which you can only deal critical damage, which does not any damage at all. Happens to me all the time when I hit somebody else's tracks. And, well, fortunately not the other way around, but that's a whole other topic. And right here, the shot in its weak spot does hit and penetrate, meaning that this thing is not fully unstoppable. So for the time being, Waffle does have some issues with that defender right there. He could, well, easier aim for his also, well, quite small but still relatively weak cupolas. But he instead wants to do the more insane shots right between the turret and the hull of the defender. That little tiny stroke in which its armor is also quite weak, but way harder to hit. But well, we see that Waffle 9000 doesn't care about, well, a very small percentage chance of hitting enemy tanks. You saw that at the start against that object, which he finally kills at this moment, clearing the city, the entire north side more in general, but now making slowly his way to the middle. And here the tortoise is actually going to find itself in a slightly more disadvantaged position. Although he still can get shots off like that. And now he has done enough to complete medium tank mission 15 for the T-55A. This is one of the few missions that I myself does not have with honors. But Waffle still needs to win this game in order to do that. So he cannot really go too much out of the open in fear of being flanked and shot on the sides, which is, well, the whole reason why the tortoise wants to be in the city most of times and not in open fields. Because it is, if it's getting caught either on the side or, well, you saw it a bit with the enemy tortoise, you do get melted quickly. This thing armor is mainly at the front. So what you do in this case, well, you still have some team members left, so it's now really the case of having some patience and wait until your friendly team members are at the right position. So he gets penetrated right on the roof out there. It's also, well, yeah, well, weak spot. It's just a very lucky shot of the enemy CS-53. Does take a moment to notice that Centurion, and unfortunately the barrel of that friendly Yak Tiger blocks his shot, but he still gets the next shot because this thing reloads insanely fast for its alpha damage. But he does let the Centurion get away, although, well, yes, he kind of let him go off. A little bit more attention to which enemies he can hit and which enemies are almost in cover. But he makes up for it for pretty good marksmanship, knowing exactly when to shoot when the SU is out of the line of its cover of those wooden wall panels. I don't know exactly the exact term of those wooden structures which act as cover. And he finally also gets the Centurion. So now it's going as quick as possible to base, and, well, quick, I mean, who are we kidding here? Quick is not really in the dictionary of the tortoise. So he has to make his way, well, as efficiently as possible in order to be on time to reset or defend the base. And how about his smaller brother, the AT-15, which is, well, tortoise small, but also with a weaker gun, weaker armor in general. But still, AT-15, well, it has still some relatively good armor. So another compliment for Waffle here is that he is on time to, well, defend the base, even though the enemy tank has already left the cap circle. Does have some issues right there with the aim. Something that I also have occasionally with non-turreted tank destroyer is when you are in sniper modus and you turn your hull, the gun will not correct itself properly. So if you turn your hull, your gun will also turn alongside it if the rotation speed of the gun itself is, well, somewhat weaker or cannot keep up with the adjustments of your hull. But he gets it eventually, also the AMX 30, which gives him the 8th kill, the Radley Walters medal, in the pocket. So what I want to say before is compliments to the positioning of Waffle in this game. Not overcommitting to the enemy base, since if he was there and the friendly base still got, well, a bit overrun by enemies, or the AT-15 couldn't handle the two enemy tanks, the game would have been lost. So a good decision of Waffle to just stay more in the middle and be on time to go you know, pretty much anywhere in the map where its help is required. And that's why you really have to pay attention on where the enemy tanks are, especially in a slow thing as the Tortoise. You really want to be at the locations where you can help out the most and not either lag behind the, well, lemming train or, well, friendly team hard push, or the, well, enemy team that, well, capture a certain area of importance or can outflank you by destroying your enemy teams in locations in which you cannot help. And ladies and gentlemen, right here, I also really want to witness a historic moment in this game, in the game in general. The Tortoise has reached the enemy cap circle. Don't see that often. If only it was slightly more than 2 minutes on the clock, it's no surprise that it took that long for the Tortoise to get here all the way. But it seems that the Lynx is not going to show its face and the team can cap out. So, of course, an ace tanker. I mean, why wouldn't it be? It was in Radley Walters alongside with a steel wall, high caliber, and top gun with nearly 8,000 damage dealt. Of course, also being top on experience with over 1,700 base experience, which on tier 9 is pretty damn nice. But he did fire pretty much all of his AP and APCR rounds in this game, meaning that he didn't make a profit even with premium account. So I pretty much have told anything I really liked about this battle, from positioning to, well, the sheer destruction that the Tortoise can do when it's hiding its weak spot properly. The only thing improvements Waffle can do here is knowing when to quit trying to shoot at enemy tanks with only a small percentage of probability to hit, and maybe pay more attention, slightly more attention towards enemy tanks that are trying to run away and trying to hide behind cover instead of enemy tanks who are in the open for a little bit longer. But, well, I can't really give too much criticism on the guy who completed medium tank mission 15 of the T-55A with honors, a mission that I still haven't managed to complete as of right now. So, great game, Waffle. Thanks for uploading your game to WOT Replays. So, that is the end of the video today. Hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you next time. Laters!